गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स. इफ यू हैव पेन इन द शोल्डर एंड डिफिकल्टी इन मूविंग द शोल्डर अप, द मोस्ट कॉमन प्रॉब्लम दैट यू मे बी हैविंग इज अ रोटेटर कफ इंजरी और अ रोटेटर कफ टेयर. A rotator cuff is basically the group of muscles which is surrounding your shoulder joint. So if you talk about your shoulder, this is the collarbone, this is the blade of the scapula, and this is your arm bone. And the rotator cuff muscle is a group of musculature which connects the shoulder blade to the arm. So, and it is a 360 degree movement. So this is the arc of the muscle which give you full motion. The muscle will help to keep your shoulder up, move it to the side, move it inwards and to the outwards. So rotator cuff muscles are the most common muscles which are important for your movement of the shoulder joint. Besides this, they will also give stability to the shoulder joint. So now if you are having pain in the shoulder along with difficulty in moving your hand up, the most common probability, as I told you, is a rotator cuff injury. Now let's talk about the main problems that you will have because of a rotator cuff injury. Number one, you will have intense pain. Now this pain is usually more in the night, and this pain can cause a difficulty in sleeping. Many patients may have disturbed sleep, many patients can have nocturnal awakenings, and many patients will not be able to sleep comfortably because of this injury. Also, you will have pain and discomfort if you will try to sleep on the same arm. So if you are sleeping on the same arm, the pain and discomfort will be too much. But the most important thing here is to realize that occasionally you may not have that severe a pain. So sometimes there is a tear, there is an injury in the rotator cuff, there is an injury in the muscle, injury in the tendon, but there is no pain. So pain is the most important problem or most important symptom, but it may not be present in all the cases. The other thing that you must understand is that the pain is not related to the severity of your injury. So some patients may have a very small tear but very, very severe pain, and some patients may have a very, very large tear but have a very, very light or very mild pain. So these things are very, very important. So you may have a very severe pain with a small rotator cuff tendon tear also, and you should not take it lightly if you don't have a pain. The second most common symptom is difficulty to lift your hand up. So there are times when you are not able to lift your shoulder up, and this is a common reason that is because of your rotator cuff injury. Because if you have a rotator cuff injury, you have weakness and you will have difficulty in taking the shoulder up. So the shoulder will become weak and you will have weakness in moving your shoulder. This is also called as pseudo paralysis. What that means is you will feel that your shoulder has become paralyzed, whereas there is no paralysis as such, but there is an injury in the tendon and in the muscle groups. Also, some patients may have problems in keep taking their hand on the back. Some patients will have problem in taking the hand up, combing the hairs. So these are many problems that the patients will face because of the rotator cuff tendon injuries. You may have crepitus coming out from the shoulder. That are different noises, tuck tuck tuck, cut cut noises, which are coming up from the shoulder joint because of the rotator cuff injury. Also, you may have pain on lifting heavy objects. So if you are taking any heavy object, keeping it up, you may have problem in that as well. Also, occasionally you may have snapping sensations inside the shoulder. So these all problems can arise because of the rotator cuff injury or a rotator cuff tear. Now, many patients ask, okay, why does this injury happen and why does this injury so common? So, let's talk about the mechanism of injury. How does this injury happen? So, there are many mechanisms, many reasons because of which this injury may happen. The most common of which is a fall on the outstretched hand. What that means is you fall down like this and the load comes on the hand and this load is transmitted to the shoulder and which leads to the rupture of your main tendon. And this is a common occurrence. You may have this injury very commonly. You may have injury inside the rotator cuff tendon because of this. So this is a very common injury and this may occur in some patients. The second most common reason is an overuse injuries. If you are using this shoulder repeatedly, like in laborers, these rotator cuff tears can occur. Also, you can have a degenerative rotator cuff tear. So if you are working and because of the age factor, the tendon may become degenerate over a period of time and that can cause tendon ruptures. There are three more very important metabolic diseases which can lead to tendon weakness, and they are hyperlipidemia, hypothyroidism and high blood sugar. That means if you have diabetes, if you have thyroid problems and if your lipid levels are high, because of all these three reasons, you may have high tendency of rotator cuff tears or rotator cuff injury. So you must be very careful, and if you have rotator cuff injury, you must investigate yourself with these three conditions. Also, occasionally in some patients, you have decrease in blood supply in the tendon area, and that may also be a reason of this injury. A very, very important reason which is seen in some of our patients is a steroid injection. In some patients, to relieve shoulder pain, many doctors give steroid injections, and a steroid is notorious of a collagenolytic effect. What that means is that the collagen, by which is the main constituent of your tendon, is denatured by the steroid, and that can cause rupture of the tendon. So steroids can cause tendon ruptures, and if you have any history of steroid injection in your shoulder and following that you are developing pain in the shoulder, you might be having problems because of that, and this is called as steroid induced rotator cuff tears. One very important reason that I must emphasize is a bony overgrowth, which is called as an impingement syndrome. And this is a very important concept, and this was given by Dr. Neitz. And Dr. Neitz explained that in your shoulder, there is a bone which is called as an acromion, and this is a hard bone, and this bone abuts your tendon. And whenever there is a rubbing of the tendon against this bone, this can cause a phenomenon which is called as a frictional abrasion of the rotator cuff tendon, and that can cause rotator cuff tendon tears. And so impingement syndrome can cause rotator cuff tendinitis, bursal sided partial tears and a complete rotator cuff tear also, and it also causes a lot of bursitis, inflammation and pain. So impingement syndrome is basically a bony overgrowth on the acromion, which is painful and which can cause a rotator cuff injury inside your shoulder. This is a very, very important concept. In some patients, the rotator cuff injury may be due to intensive overhead activity like overhead sports. It may be badminton, it may be tennis, it may be javelin throw, it may be any overhead sport. So if you are doing any overhead sports, you stand at a chance of sustaining a rotator cuff injury. Now suppose if you have these problems and because of these all injuries, you are having pain in the shoulder and difficulty in taking your shoulder up, then what should you do? The most important concept here is you must consult a doctor who is a specialist in shoulder. So we recommend you to see a shoulder specialist. Shoulder specialist is usually a super specialist which is trained in orthopedic surgery as a basic your description, and then he has taken a super specialty training in a shoulder surgery. The shoulder expert will do your few examination and he will evaluate three things. One, your pain. Two, your movements. And three, your strength. So he will evaluate your pain. He will evaluate the movement, how much you are able to take your shoulder up, take your shoulder to the side, and how much movement you are able to do with your shoulder. And what is the strength of your shoulder? Is your shoulder strong enough to take up, down, sideways, and what is the power of your shoulder? So he will evaluate everything, and in some particular circumstances he may also do some specific tests, the most common of which are Needs test and Hawkins test. Needs test and Hawkins test are both done to evaluate impingement syndrome, that is the bony overgrowth impinging on your rotator cuff tendons. And if these are positive, it is suggestive of impingement syndrome, and along with your rotator cuff problem, you should always address the bony problem in these particular cases. Once your doctor has a suspicion of this problem, he will advise you x-rays, which is a very basic investigation, and that needs to be done to rule out any calcium deposits in the shoulder and any arthritis in the shoulder as well. The classical investigation which should be done in all patients to diagnose rotator cuff injury, this problem, is a MRI scan of the shoulder. An MRI scan is basically a magnetic resonant imaging of the shoulder, and this should be done in all patients in which we suspect a rotator cuff tear injury. Ideally, I recommend that minimum 1.5 Tesla MRI should be advised in most of the patients, because if you do an MRI less than that, you may have a poor sensitivity. So always do a 1.5 Tesla plus. If it is 3 Tesla, it is good. MRI scan, the sensitivity is 98%. Most of the patients, most of the diagnosis can be picked up with the MRI scan. Now, I would like to tell you there is one more investigation which is called as an ultrasound. An ultrasound is basically a user dependent investigation. It is around 80% sensitive, and it is usually advised at some special centers. We don't routinely advise ultrasonography for rotator cuff injuries. Magnetic resonance imaging is the best investigation if you have a doubt regarding a rotator cuff injury. Some people recommend an injection in the shoulder and taking MRI after that. This is called as an MR arthrogram, that is magnetic resonance arthrogram. But this is not indicated in most of the cases, and we don't recommend this as a normal practice owing to a very good machines nowadays, very good technology nowadays of a simple plain MRI scan. Ultrasounds are not very useful, as I told you earlier, because of the low sensitivity, 80% of the sensitivity, and there is also a problem of user dependency. What that means is, if you have a good radiologist, the results are better, the sensitivity is better. If the radiologist is not that experienced, the result may not be that good. So now, once the diagnosis is established, what about the treatment? What to do? So now, we will just talk about what kind of diagnosis can be there. You may have a partial injury to the rotator cuff tear, rotator cuff, or you may have a complete injury to the rotator cuff tear. So if you have a partial injury, that means about a part of the rotator cuff tear is torn, then you may be treated conservatively. That means you may be advised physiotherapy and exercises and medications, and you may not need a surgery. Specifically, if your injury or if your tear is less than 50%. If your tear and if your injury is more than 50%, you may still need an arthroscopic repair or an arthroscopic surgery. But If you have an injury which is a complete rotator cuff tear, complete supraspinatus tear, then ideally you should get an arthroscopic rotator cuff tendon repair surgery. And this is the gold standard surgery in present time. So if you have a rotator cuff tear injury, the best treatment for you is an arthroscopic rotator cuff tear repair surgery. Some people ask me that why not open surgery? We don't want cosmesis, we are old patients, we don't need a good scar, but we need a good result. So that is the reason. We don't do arthroscopic surgery for cosmesis. We do arthroscopic surgery for an excellent long-term outcomes, because arthroscopic surgery made your results very much precise. We can address each and every part of the shoulder very precisely. We can address all the injuries very precisely by the use of arthroscopic surgery. And that is why arthroscopic surgery is the best treatment for these patients. Not only that, the accuracy of the arthroscopic surgery is high, the results, the immediate post-op results, the immediately post-op pain is low, the rehabilitation is easier, the physiotherapy is easier, going back to your sports or back to your activities easier, the overall scars are smaller, overall pain is less. So there are numerous advantages with the arthroscopic surgery. And there are some injuries which cannot be addressed open, because if you are doing an open rotator cuff repair, you will not be able to address biceps pathology, subscapularis pathology. They will be missed. So all the pathologies of the shoulder will be addressed, whole of the shoulder joint can be examined, and more accurate repair can be performed. So by and large, arthroscopic surgery is the best treatment at the present time for rotator cuff injury. Now, many patients ask me what is the best technique of rotator cuff tear repair. So there are two techniques. One is a single row, one is a double row. Single row is an olden technique and works on the point fixation, and we put a single row of the anchors to repair the rotator cuff, and it is a point fixation technique. Whereas a double row is an area fixation technique. We fix the rotator cuff tendon over a broad area. Usually nowadays rotator cuff tendons should be fixed predominantly with a double row technique, because it increases the healing rate and improves the surgical outcomes. Now, coming to prevention, this is a very important topic, and many patients have asked me, doctor, the treatment is covered in lot of videos, but what about prevention and how can we prevent this kind of injury? Because as you know, that if there is a rotator cuff tendon complete tear, there is no other treatment. You need to get it repaired, but how can you prevent it? So these are very important tips and tricks that you must all know. You should avoid heavy activity and lifting heavy weight sparingly. So if you are not used to lifting heavy weight, don't lift heavy weight. That is number one. Number two, do strengthening exercises with TheraBand. So if you do strengthening exercise, if you do TheraBand exercises, the muscles will become stronger and the chance of rupture and chance of tear, re-tear will reduce. The other important thing is, as I told you about the metabolic syndromes, hyperlipidemia, hypothyroidism and diabetes. So these all things have to be keep in control. So if you have diabetes, keep your sugar in control. If you have thyroid, make sure that your thyroid levels are in normal range. If you have lipid problems, you have lipid levels in the normal range. So make sure that all these levels are in normal range. And avoid any kind of heavy weight lifting, specifically overhead activity. So if you are doing overhead sporting activities, be very careful. So if you take all these precautions, you can reduce or minimize the chances of rotator cuff tendon injuries. So friends, I hope that with this video, I am able to clear all your doubts pertaining to the rotator cuff tendon tears. If you have any more doubts, you can contact us on the comment box. If you need an online appointment, you can schedule an online appointment by dialing onto the number which is given in the description box. Friends, if you need any more help, we'll be more than happy to help you out. थैंक्स अ लॉट डॉक्टर प्रथमेश जैन, एडवांस नी एंड शोल्डर हॉस्पिटल अहमदाबाद।